Thank you. Welcome if you come here now and again. Welcome if this place holds a special place in your heart. And welcome if you call this place home, because you're here most weeks. Welcome to the service of the year where anything could happen, and usually does. So do sit back and do enjoy our time together. We're going to begin by praying together in a minute, and we're going to light four of the Advent candles, because you know what happened today? I got a Sunday morning off, and so it's a bit unusual working on a Sunday afternoon, isn't it? So yeah, so here we go. Right, who's going to light the first one? Go on, thanks. You can light that purple one. Any of the purple ones you can light.
It's Christmas Eve. We've had lots of fun with school nativities, work Christmas do's, as well as many other festive activities. So give me a cheer and clap your hands if you're excited about Christmas Day. Come on, that's terrible. Are you really excited?
Thank you, thank you. I know, I am quite brilliant. Thank you, thank you.
Professor Potion, what are you doing? They're not clapping for you.
They're not?
No, they're clapping because they love Christmas. Why would they be clapping for you? You haven't done anything.
Oh, well, that's not quite true. I have been very, very busy. Busy doing what exactly? Busy preparing for a very important experiment. An experiment which will be explosive.
Wow, sounds exciting. I'll leave you to it then, Professor.
You see, what I want to find out is this. What makes Christmas so brilliantly special? What makes Christmas go with a bang? So I have come up with what I think is the formula for the perfect Christmas. And I think that if I follow this formula very, very carefully, then we should be able to produce a fantabulous Christmas. So let's see, what do we need? Christmas presents. How can I be sure that I need you in my Christmas formula? Yes, you're right. What would Christmas be without presents? In you go. Father Christmas, I don't need you. You're just for the children.
Ho, ho, ho. Why are you so grumpy? Everyone needs a little bit of Santa at Christmas time. I bring out the laughter and the mystery to Christmas. Find your Christmas cheer, Mr. Grumpy.
Professor Grumpy to you. No, no, I'm not grumpy at all. Get in. Ho, ho, ho indeed. What have you got to do with Christmas?
I'm only for Christmas. Without Christmas, I've got nothing to do. You see, the rest of my year is terrible. I'm not a big tree, so all the other trees ignore me, and I'm so much bigger than a plant, so they're all scared of me. But then, once a year, I get covered in tinsel and baubles and sparkly lights with a star on top. I'm indoors, all warm and cosy, with presents underneath and happiness all around me. Don't take that away from me. Please let me in.
All right, you can be in my Christmas. You're pulling my leg. This is just silly now. I am a big, soft, fluffy teddy bear. Of course you can come in. So, we have our prolific Christmas already. Now for the bang, we must get ready. Go plug it in. I said go plug it in. Just need to plug it in. Oh, it won't stretch. Ding! Now for the drum roll. Now let's count down from five. Five, four, three, two, one! Oh, what has gone wrong? I have all the ingredients. I have checked, and I have double-checked, and the formula was correct. Oh, what is this? A missing ingredient? What's the missing ingredient? A baby Jesus? What is a baby Jesus? Can a little baby in a crib really make a difference to Christmas? Well, let's add a baby Jesus and find out.
Thank you.
Now let's count down from five again. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh yay, there's balloons. Have you seen anything like that? This is very strange. The crucial secret ingredient to a prolific Christmas is a little baby. This is just making my head ache. I just don't understand. My calculations are all wrong.
The professor's got it. Don't you see? She's worked out something huge. She's worked out that in order for Christmas to go with a bang, you need Jesus.
Jesus is the reason for Christmas. It's the celebration of his birthday, the day when we remember that he was born in the stinky stable in Bethlehem. It's all about him.
We all love Father Christmas. Christmas trees, roast turkey, reindeers, mince pies and all the rest. The thing that makes Christmas brilliantly special is the fact that Jesus is brilliantly special.
The Bible teaches us that Jesus is God's very own Son, sent from heaven to earth to be God with us.
To wait for. It is amazing, and it is the reason that 2,000 years later we are still celebrating Jesus.
So in order for our Christmases to go off an explosive great big bang and be the best they can be, we need to remember Jesus in all our celebrations.
We're going to stand in a moment and sing our next carol before we think a bit more about what it means to wish it would be Christmas every day. Before I do that, I have a feeling that one of you might wish that someone had found their phone. Because we found this phone in the toilets. Not the greatest place in the world. Now I could sort of like, I was trying to work out whether to tell you whose it was, but there's some bit of white noise, dodgy baby music. So I'm not quite sure whose it is, but if you come and see me at the end, we'll give it to you then. Shall we stand together? We're going to sing Joy to the World.
Thank you.
a seat. Now, I was thinking about that song there. I wish it could be Christmas every day. And my guess is, for some of us, we wish it could be Christmas every day. Yeah? So I thought, anyone ever made a Christmas wish list? Anyone ever made a Christmas wish list? Am I the only one ever who's made a Christmas wish list? You know, when I was 11 years old, I made this wish list that I would get a bike. And in 1981, at Christmas, the angels appeared in the sky. And good news of great joy came before me. And there before me was a Mark II ultraviolet rally chopper bike. Now, who's ridden a rally chopper bike? If you've ridden a rally chopper bike, you know it is the Harley Davidson of bikes. And that if you haven't, you've just missed out. But I got my thought. Anyone made a Christmas wish list this year? Anyone? Where's the mic? The mic's gone. Right. Who's going to tell me what's the number one thing on your wish list this year for Christmas?
Whatever I say.
Say that again. Did you understand that?
A robot that does whatever Rafe says.
A robot that does whatever you say. I'm just looking at his parents. It's not going to happen. go on, tell me, what's on your Christmas wish list? A water bottle. Oh, well, I can do that. Where's your dad? Your dad can do that. Yeah. Anyone else got anything else on their Christmas wish list this year? Go on, what's on your Christmas wish list?
Sweets.
I can do that as well. Oh, what's on your Christmas wish list? Go on.
Hermione's wand.
A what? Hermione's wand. Is that from Harry Potter?
Yeah.
You know, should I let you into a secret? How many Harry Potter books have you read? Do you know how many? How many films have you watched? Have you watched any? Half of one. You know what? That's half more than me. Go on.
A mini Tesla.
A mini Tesla. Well, I know your dad drives rally cars, but I'm not sure about the mini Tesla. Are you going to get a mini Tesla? He's looking at you. Listen, if you get the mini Tesla, will it bring it round to my house? And I can get my rally chopper bike out, and we can have a go together. Now, I didn't make a Christmas wish list this year, but what I did was, I found this. It's one of my children's Christmas wish lists. Who wants to read something of what? Harry, come over here. Now, it will remain nameless of my children, basically, which one it was. Harry, wait, just come here. There we go. Right. Do you want to start by that? What does that say?
Emma's.
Oh. You're not meant to tell her. Listen, I told you a little lie, I did get a wish list. Because my daughter Emma has been in Hong Kong. And yesterday at 3 o'clock, she flew back. And she landed in Heathrow this morning and missed her connection. And I was thinking, and she came home at 2:30. So I did get my wish list. So what was the first thing on Emma's wish list? Go on, what's it?
An iPad Touch.
An iPod.
An iPod Touch.
Do you know what an iPod Touch is? You see, anyone know what an iPod Touch is? You see, plenty of us. But you see, you know, before iPhones, before one of these, they were kind of like the thing that you just played music on. You didn't talk into them. But she's very good. She's put, and well, with earphones and that stuff. What was the second thing on the iPod list, on the list?
Case for the iPod.
She's very practical, my daughter, isn't she? Case for the iPod Touch. I mean, it's a bit dated. What's the third thing? Let me tell you, Harry, this list was, I reckon, written about 13 years ago. She has not changed. In fact, she got to the airport this morning and she said, Dad, would you transfer me some money? I haven't got any money. And that is literally a true story. Thank you. You know,
We maybe wish it could be Christmas every day. And that's a really popular song. But does anybody know what the best-selling Christmas record is ever? It's not Last Christmas. It's got a bit of a clue because it's got a bit of a wish list idea to it. Anybody know? Pardon? Go on, tell us.
All I want for Christmas.
All I want for Christmas. You see, all they want for Christmas over there at the moment is a fire extinguisher. But literally. But it got me thinking, you know, for some of you maybe, Mariah Carey in a Father Christmas costume singing All I Want for Christmas would be your perfect Christmas. But it would be better, wouldn't it, than what it was a few years before that. All I want for Christmas is my two front teeth. But it got me thinking, you know, what would God want for Christmas? Yeah, what God wants for Christmas is you, and you, and you, and you, and you, and you, and you. He wants to love you, and for you to love him. He wants to know you. You see, in the Bible, God doesn't so much make wishes. He makes promises. And he makes a list of them that we can all know. And all of those promises we find have their yes in Jesus. In other words, he is the reason for those promises. Most of all, he wants you to know the promise of why he came, that he loves you, and he wants to be your savior, because that's what Jesus means. And he makes a promise, a special promise, that we're going to sing about now, because one of the promises that Jesus promises to bring is the promise of his peace, because he's the Prince of Peace who came to bring peace on earth. So we're going to sing that song now, aren't we? This is a special song that the children have been learning. And I think some of the bebops have been learning it as well. And some of their mums are going to come out as well, or some of their carers. So if you know the song, why don't you come and join us up here? Yeah, of course you can. It's on.
Peace.
stay there. Just stay there. Sorry. Just stay there a minute. Just stay there a minute. So in a moment we're going to sing our final carol together, but two things. If you want to think a bit more about what it means for Jesus to be the Prince of Peace, then we have these books, all sorts, adult, kids' books alike, just on the table if you want to take one as you go out. Secondly, people often ask me at services like this, how can I make a donation to the church? Well, actually, if you want to make a donation to the church, all the money that we make at Christmas, we give away. And so there's a QR code on various different pieces of paper by the door. All the money that we're giving away this year is actually going to the place of Jesus' birth. It's going to Bethlehem in the West Bank of Israel. So if you want to make a donation, you can do it there or you can do it online. We don't take cash anymore, basically. So if that's what you want to do, then that's entirely up to you. Why don't we stand together? We're going to sing our final carol together. Hark the herald angels sing. Blessing together. May the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the perseverance of the wise men, the obedience of Joseph and Mary, and the peace of Jesus the Christ child be yours this Christmas. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Just before we close, I would like to just say a big thank you to Sally, to Sam, to some of the parents as well who've been, how shall we say, cajoling, encouraging, drilling those children who were absolutely fabulous. So should we give them a big round of applause? Thank you. And to wish you all a happy Christmas.